Welcome to Psych Terms, where we define and describe some difficult to understand psychological terms, while also giving examples that might be able to illustrate them in a different light. Today we're talking about drive reduction theory. This is the idea that a physiological need creates an aroused tension state, or a drive, that motivates an organism to satisfy that need. So we all have physiological needs, whether it's trying to get out of the heat, maybe we're hungry, or maybe we're just thirsty. And those create motivated states, or a drive, such as hunger or thirst. That really pushes us to reduce that need. So with drive reduction theory, when our physiological needs increase, so does our physiological drive to reduce it. Now this concept really goes hand in hand with the idea of homeostasis, or a tendency to maintain a balanced or constant internal state. This is the regulation of any aspect of body chemistry, such as blood glucose, around a particular level. So when we're hungry, when we're thirsty, when our body temperature is too high or too low, sometimes we require other things to help mediate that and bring it back to balance or a baseline. Whether it is water or food or a different type of temperature, it's usually helping us out and bringing us back to homeostasis. Now, not only are we pushed by the needs to reduce our drives, but we're also pulled by incentives. And an incentive is a positive or negative environmental stimulus that motivates our behavior. Now, this is usually influenced by our previous experiences or our learning. So if you smell the aroma of freshly cooked food, and that's something that motivates you to quench your hunger, then that's going to be an influencing incentive that pulls you towards it. So for example, let's say you're hungry. That would be your instinctual drive, something that you have to reduce in order to get back to homeostasis or a baseline. So you would see something like a pizza, smell the aromas coming off that pizza fresh out of the oven, and that would be the incentive. The pizza is pulling you towards it so that you can satisfy or reduce that drive of hunger. Now, when there is both a need and an incentive, we feel strongly driven to reduce that drive. That person that's extremely hungry may pay out more money based upon their hunger because that pizza is in front of them and they can physically see it. Let's use another example. Let's say you're biking, and you've been biking for quite some time, but you still have quite a ways to go. You end up being thirsty because you're overexerting yourself, and you see a water bottle. So you have a particular need, which is thirst, and seeing the water bottle would be the incentive that pulls you towards it. So your need, your incentive, and the drive is to reduce your thirst. So you would take that bottle, you'd drink it, and through drive reduction theory, everything would have aligned for you to drink and return to homeostasis. According to this example, we can see drive reduction theory at work. So if we are water deprived, our thirst drives us to drink and to restore our body's normal states. While drive reduction theory doesn't explain all motivations, it's a good explanation for when our physiological needs increase, so do our physiological drives to reduce them.